This is a video to show you how to use Promethean ActivInspire's desktop annotation tool. If you do not already have ActivInspire open, go ahead and open ActivInspire. When you do, the dashboard will appear. On the dashboard, you can immediately start annotating over your desktop by clicking the Annotate Over Desktop button. Or if you do not have the dashboard open, you can click on the Desktop Annotate tool on the toolbox. When you click on that tool, it's going to appear as though ActivInspire has closed, when in actuality it's just been minimized down to the task pane. Your toolbox is still going to show up, your browser panel will still appear, and the trash can will still appear as well. I'm going to go ahead and close the trash can and the browser to give me more room. Basically what has happened is you have a transparency kind of over the screen, so you can write on your desktop, you can use the pen on the Promethean board, or if you have a slate you can use the pen as well. So you can use the mouse using the select tool to navigate on the internet in a program, for example. So if I'm on the educational technology website, I can click on Edmodo and it will bring me to the Edmodo website. I can then use the tools to, for example, I can use the pen tool, and if I want students to click on this I'm a student button, I can come down here and I can circle it and point to it and say, this is the button that I need you to click on. And then the students can click on that button, and once they do, the annotations are still going to stay there. So I can either use the eraser tool and I can erase those, or I can use this clear and I can clear all annotations from my screen. So now let's say I need students to make sure they enter in a certain group code. So I can highlight that area, use the pen tool, and I can actually write that group code on the board that I want the students to be able to type in. And then they need to type in their username. Maybe that's going to be their student ID number. So I can actually write student ID on the board using either a slate, an active slate with a pen, or actually writing it on the board. I can tell them what I want their password to be. I can tell them we're not going to put an email address. And then I can tell them to put their actual first name and their actual last name into the boxes. They'll have to check here, and then we're going to click sign up as the last step. So now I've annotated over their screen, so if some students are working faster than others, they can go ahead and fill out all that information. Once I'm done using this and all the students are done, I can clear everything off, and then I can return to my ActivInspire flip chart by clicking again on the desktop annotate button, and that will bring me back to my flip chart. So this was ActivInspire's desktop annotate tool.